application programming wizard. Now for today, we're going to see how to make an HTTP GET request to our server, then retrieve some data, and then fill our list view. Now for us, of course, if you can see right here, we're having our data, okay? This is our database right here. Now you can see, for instance, I'm having StressCraftDB, my database name, then my table right here. What you want is this first column right here, okay? Want to request this one, and of course we shall be requesting it via PHP. So what we do, we simply come click our file, but of course you are going to write some PHP code. Now for me, I've written mine. Take note of where I've saved it. Inside I'm using the WAMP server, so WAMP www directory, then I've created a folder over there that I've called Android. This is my PHP script. If you come right here, it's a very simple script. You can see first we specify our host name, then the username, which is root, the password blank, then the database name. We connect our database. If you have an error, we display it. These are SQL statements. You are selecting everything from our spacecraft table, which is our table name. Okay, then we come right here. Our MySQL query, we pass in connection, then SQL statement. This is going to return a boolean if true. Then we're going to fetch row by row. Okay, by calling this fetch array right here, we pass in our result. Then we assign to this particular row. Then from this particular row, we shall be adding this data to our array right here. At the end of the day, we JSON encode this array, of course, and then does it. So if we run Android application, this is what we're going to be ending up. This a large array string, a JSON string, okay? Of course, we make sure that we close our connection. These are PHP code. You just make sure that you save it in the root directory of your server. For me, my root directory, of course, as you can see right here, is this particular www. But again, I've created a folder that I've called Android. That's where I'm saving mine. So that's it. Let's proceed on. Here I'm going to create a project. I've already created mine. Go to file, new project, choose Android project. Okay, we're going to convert it from Google scripts. We really have nothing really that much to add. Let's just see right here. Okay, I'm actually using a simple list view, so we're not going to need any. We won't need any dependency apart from what our list view is going to generate for us. You can see right here, of course, the app compart, and then of course this support design library. So this is it. This is my Gradle script right here. We'll be just going to leave it intact. We'll be able to just generate for us. The next thing that we're going to move to is our manifest. Remember, we shall be making an HTTP GET request, okay, using of course our HTTP URL connection class. So for this one, we shall be talking to our internet. So we're going to our connection. In this case, we now need to add the permission for connection to the internet. So please just make sure that you have this particular permission, because you want to be able to talk to our server. So once we've done that one, then of course in our layouts once more, we really have nothing special apart from what we just did in the program. Only that we come here and then make sure that we add our list view. So come here, add your list view, it's a simple list view. Then of course assign it an ID. To do, let's come over right here to our code. Then you can create a package right here by right clicking the new package. I've created a package and called it MySQL right here. You can see we're having three classes: connector, data parser, and then of course downloader class. So what is it that you're doing? Well, first of course we're connecting. Okay, we're connecting, we're establishing a connection to our server. We shall be using the HTTP URL connection, and then of course we shall set its property to allow us to get a GET request. So that's it. This is where we shall perform that one inside our connector class. Then we're also going to have to download data. Of course, we connect, then we'll need to retrieve data. We're going to have this data, we'll download it as a form, as a JSON string. Now once we have it, we're going to pass it, and that's where we're going to use the data parser class. So for us, the downloader and then the data parser class, these are two things we shall be doing in the background thread using our async task. So that's it. Let's get started with our connector class. So first, you can see right here what the role of this class, of course, as we said, is to help us establish our connection to our server. And that one, what we're going to be doing is very simple. Right here, we're going to have this simple method we're calling connect method. Okay, we'll pass in a URL address, and then inside our try catch loop, the first thing we're going to come over right here, then just instantiate our java.net.url, passing in our URL address. This is going to give us a URL object, and then that particular URL we shall use it to open a connection, and then of course assign the resolve here to our HTTP URL connection. So then we set the properties for this particular connection. We are saying we are making a GET request. Now with a GET request, we won't be modifying any resource in our server, okay? If you make unlike a POST request with a GET request, you only read, it's a read-only request, you only read data, and that's what actually we're interested in, okay? If suppose we are able to do some modifications, maybe insert or save or something like that or update, then we would have used the HTTP POST. And in fact, in the previous, we have a previous tutorial which we talked about HTTP POST. So for us, that's it. That's our request method. We're also going to need to set our connect timeout. This is how long our connection is going to take, okay? Before it exits, this will going to take 15k milliseconds, that is 15 seconds. Our read timeout is also going to be 15 seconds. Then of course, these are connections going to support input. Remember, we're inputting data, we are downloading data from applications. So that's it, we set it to true. At the end of the day, we return our connection to URL connection object creatures. What about if we have an error? Well, if we're having a malformed URL exception, that is if we specified URL in the wrong format, we're going to throw at this particular message. And then of course take note right here, error, p.get message, we're starting with the term error, also right here, error, then p.get message when you have an input output and exception. So that's it guys, this is our connector class. It's going to help us establish our connection to our server. Once we've established our connection, what next should we do? Okay, of course, before we pass our data, we need to download that particular data that we want to pass. So this brings us to our downloader class. This particular class right here is going to be a threading class. So the first thing that we're going to do, we're going to make it derived from asynchronous code. Okay? Then of course our first param right here, what we shall be passing to our bin background, because it's void. And then also what we're going to be passing to our progress update, void. And then lastly, what shall be returned by the doing background, or actually what we shall be passing to our process, and in this case going to be a string. So that's it, that's going to give us this one. Then of course with this one, we'll need to come and then implement. So implement at least our doing background method. So yes, we do so, okay. Apart from that one, okay, before we will also need to come right here and then implement our own pre-execute method. Then lastly of course we're also going to need to just override our own pre-execute. So before we come to those particular methods that we've already, let's come over right here. We're going to create a constructor, take note of these three: context, URL address, and then the list rule. We're going to need them. So for us, we're going to pass them to our constructor. So alt insert, then we come right here, constructor. We're going to need context, URL address, and of course our list rule. So yes, we're going to pass them to our constructor. Then of course the next thing, inside our own pre-execute method right here, we shall come, and then this is what we're going to do. First, take note of our progress dialog, instantiate it, passing in our context. Then we come right here, set its title, set the message, and then show it. Of course, once we showed it, we'll also need at the end of the day to come and dismiss it. So pd, we'll call our dismiss. That's it for our that's it for of course our own pre-execute method, and of course our own post-execute. The next thing is we're going to come right here, then create a simple method that's going to help us actually download our data. So for this our method, we're going to make it return for our string. We're going to call it download data. This is it. So the first thing that we're going to do right here is very simple. Now what we're going to do, we're going to establish our connection, okay? Remember we have our connector class, so yes, we're going to come with here, send it to an object. I'm going to call it connection. Then we're simply going to call our connector class. Remember we have the connector class. So we come connector, then we call our connector method. We pass in our level address. Then the first thing we're going to come right here, check if our connection go to string. Okay, then we check if it starts with an error. If that's the case, starts with an error, then what are you going to do? Well, what we're going to do right here, we're going to return null. Okay, so in fact, what we're going to do is just come right here and then return this connection to string. a connection by posting. That's what we're going to post return and post exit over there. We won't try to download data if our connection starts with an error. So remember, starts with error right here. We specify that one inside right here. Okay, if you throw an error, then we're going to touch the error message in front of the MSI. Then, of course, the next thing that we're going to do right here, we're going to actually download our data. Now, to download our data is simple. First, we do it inside our tray catch block. Now, we've already got our connection right here. What we do, of course, if it starts with an error, we're going to exit. Otherwise, we'll come right here. Then, cast it to an HTTP URL connection. So, yes, once we have that one, we're going to come, insert our input stream. Then, of course, we're going to make it buffered. So, we come just right here. Input stream is equal to new buffer input stream. Then we pass in our input stream, get it from our corner, our HTTP URL connection instance. Now once we have that one, we're going to come read your buffer reader. This is going to help us read our data. So equal to new buffer reader, then we pass this particular input stream reader, okay, which is going to of course actually read our data. So once we have that one, we come right here. We're going to have a stream that we're calling line. This is going to call for that we shall be reading line by line. So each particular line we shall be holding temporarily inside this particular line stream right here. Then JSON data, this is a string buffer. So all these particular lines we shall be attaching them or appending them to a JSON data, which is a string buffer. So as to read, we come right here, line equal to BRF line. At the same time, we're checking if it's not null. If that's the case, then of course we come right here, append our line. And of course, at the end of the day, we make sure that we release our resources by closing our buffered reader and also closing our input stream. So yes, once we've done that one, of course, we're going to come right here. Then return our JSON data to string. So we shall be returning it as a string. Otherwise, we'll come right here and return once more. Our error is going to start with the term error, then come right here, then E, dot get message. Okay, so we're going to use the get message right here. So once we have that one, of course, that's going to define our download data method. It's quite simple. We come right here to implement it. We'll simply come right here, this dot download data is going to download for us our data. Okay, so that's it. We'll then come over to our on post execute right here. Now basically what we're going to do inside it is very simple. We just come right here and then we're going to check if, remember, we're receiving a JSON data right here. So JSON data, okay, where are we receiving it from? Well, we're receiving it from our bin background. This particular method shall execute for us our download of data right here, then return a string, which is a JSON data, and pass it right here. There's a possibility that you can know. Okay, if it's not null, not really null right here. We're going to say if JSON data, okay, then it starts with, let's come right here and starts with the term error. If this is the case, remember our error was starting with the term error, okay? If this is the case, then we're going to say unsuccessful. In fact, then we're going to show that particular message so that can help us also in debugging. So right here we're going to say then we display the particular JSON data. Okay, so right here it's a string. What is it? Okay, this is not here. So we display it right here. Otherwise if that's not the case, then we're going to proceed on and then of course pass our data. So that brings us next to have to of course our data pass across. Now we have an error right here. Let's take a look. So let's come over right here. Okay, it's this one over right here. So let's come and make sure that we close this one. So guys, this is it. This is our downloader class. Downloader class, we're going to move to our data parser class. Data parser class, once more, this is a class. This is the right here where we're going to pass our data. Okay, we'll pass it. We're going to be receiving a JSON string. This is what we're going to pass, and then of course bind it to our list view. So the first thing that we're going to do right here is very simple. We're going to make this class to of course derive from async task. Okay, now once we've done that one, then of course we'll come right here with our constructor. We shall be passing these three parameters right here: context, JSON data, and then this way. Where shall we be passing them from? Well, from our downloader class, remember, we shall pass our context, JSON data. This is that of course we need to be passing, and then of course the list row where we shall need to bind that particular data. Of course, This is also an async task right here. It's a subclass of async task. So what we're going to do first, of course, we're also going to show our right here. We're going to have our own print execution method where we're going to, of course, initialize our progress dialog. Then, of course, we're also going to have our doing background method. So we shall come right here, have our doing background method. And then, of course, lastly, we're also going to have our own post execute. So this is it. We shall be passing in our background thread. Now you can see right here, before we start our processing, then we show our progress dialog. Now processing we're going to perform inside this doing background. Then of course on post execute, the method gets what's called once we're through with the passing of our data. So for us, what we're going to do is very simple. We're going to have right here method that's going to return for us a boolean. This method we're going to call it. We're going to call it what pass data. Let's call it pass data. Okay. So if we are going to have an error, we shall be returning false. Otherwise, we'll come over right here. Then inside our try catch block, this way shall be, of course, passing our JSON file. So guys, for us, this is it. It's going to be simple. First, right here, you are just initializing the JSON array. You are passing data to it. Okay, a JSON data that we shall be receiving. Then we also need to declare on a JSON object. Now for us, remember we have this particular spacecraft array list right here. This array list right here is going to hold for us all our spacecraft that we're going to receive from our database. So we come, we just clear it. When we come in a for loop, we're going to look through, of course, our JSON array. So ja.a++. The first thing that we're doing, we're getting a JSON object from our JSON array. So we just pass our index right here, of course, to our JSON array. So we'll get JSON object, then we end up with that JSON object. So once we have our JSON object right here, we can just come and then get the name. So get string right here and the name. Now take note right here, this you have to be clean right here. This is the name of the column in your database. So come right here, the name of the column, pass it right here exactly the way it is in your database. Then of course make sure that you add the name spacecraft collection, then we return true. Okay, otherwise we shall be catching a JSON exception and then returning false. So of course to implement this one, we said we will be passing in our bug. So of course first make sure that your server is up. Okay, then we come click our fab button right here. You can see everything gets ready. First you see it shows us the true progress dialog. So if we click a single item, we'll get the item that we click. Guys, this is it. I'm hoping you guys have enjoyed the tutorial. Please, if you have, hit the like button, share this video with friends, and also make sure that you subscribe so that you never miss any of our Android tutorials. We normally do post tutorials quite regularly. Take care, catch you in the next tutorial.